Good morning, students. Today in this session, I will be discussing with you your poem, The Gift of India by Sarojini Naidu from your Reverie book. Before starting the session, children, I want to mention that you have to revise the poem thoroughly so that you can quote the important lines and keywords from your poem. Before starting the session, let us see the objectives. By the end of this session, you will be able to understand the summary of the poem, understand the theme of the poem, understand the background of the poem. Now let us start with about the author. You have to open your Reverie workbook. Sarojini Naidu was a great patriot, freedom fighter, and poet of modern India. She was born in a Bengali family on February 13, 1879 at Hyderabad and was educated in Chennai, London and Cambridge. She took part in the national movement, became a follower of Gandhiji and fought for the attainment of Swaraj. Known as the Nightingale of India, she composed poetry in which swift thoughts and strong emotions sprang into lyrics by themselves. Sarojini Naidu's The Gift of India is an emotionally charged response to the martyrdom of Indian soldiers in foreign lands during the First World War. So the backdrop of our poem is during the First World War, where the Indian soldiers fought for the Britishers. Now let us continue. It is a poem in which Mother India herself speaks of the love, devotion and heroism of her children. Her children here refers to Indian soldiers who fought for the Britishers. She speaks of the precious gifts that she has offered to the world, the most important being the gift of her children's lives. So she has sacrificed her children's life for another country. Now let us discuss the story in brief. For this you have to open your workbook at page number 61. So let us start with the brief summary. Mother India asks the British who have colonized India if she has withheld any of her riches from them, like raiments, grains or gold. So who is the speaker here? The speaker is Mother India. The poem, The Gift of India, is an elegy. Now, what is elegy? It is a poem or song that expresses sadness, especially for somebody who has died. So, it expresses grief on the death of Indian soldiers. So, the poem, The Gift of India, is an elegy written in a lyric. Now, lyric is expressing personal feelings and thoughts spoken in first person. And who is speaking in first person? It is Mother India. So let us start. First of all, meaning of word colonized. It means to take control of another country or place and make it a colony. The next word is withheld. It means to hold something back. Raiments means clothing. So the poet addresses the rulers of India, the British, in an anguished tone. And who is the speaker? The speaker is not the poet. It is Mother India. So in which tone Mother India is speaking to Britishers? In an anguished tone. So in an anguished tone, the Mother India asked the Britishers, who were the ruler of India at that time, who had taken away many precious things from her, that is rich clothes, grains and gold. She has given away from her bosom her priceless treasures, alluding to Indian sons, to the eastern and the western countries. Now let us see the meaning of word bosom. It means chest. Priceless treasures here refers to the Indian soldiers who sacrificed their lives during the First World War. Alluding refers to refer something in an indirect manner. So children, the poem is a tribute to brave Indian soldiers who fought bravely during the World War I, that is from 1914 to 1918. About 1 million Indian soldiers were sent to fight in distant lands in Asia, Middle East and Europe by the colonial masters, the British. These soldiers listened to the call of their duty and did their best even without knowing why they were fighting. So in the poem, The Gift of India, Mother India is asking the British who had snatched away her priceless gifts. Now, who are her priceless gifts? That is her dear sons. Her dear sons here refers to Indian soldiers whom they sent to fight on their behalf to the distant lands. Now, let us see the next slide. Her brave offsprings have often been summoned abroad to the call of duty. Offspring here refers to children. Summoned means called. So, who were being called for their duty? Yes. The Indian soldiers were called to the duty by the British. So as Indian soldiers were so duty conscious, they thought that being soldiers, it was their duty to go and fight. The dead bodies of Indian soldiers who have sacrificed their lives like pearls lie buried in alien lands. They are scattered like shells on Egyptian sands. They sleep silently along the Persian waves, and withered flowers are scattered over the meadows of Flanders and France. Now let us see the meaning first. The meaning of word alien means another country. Withered means to become dry and die. Meadows means a field of grass. Now children, the Indian soldiers were sent to fight the enemy in Persia and Egypt. They fought bravely and many of them were killed. Now what happened to their dead bodies? Their dead bodies are likened to scattered pearls and shells on the sea beaches and in the sandy deserts. Means they were in bad condition with pale foreheads and broken hands. They were like flowers scattered in meadows of Flanders and France. The poet has used similes which we will read in the poem to express these lines. Her grief at the loss of her son is immeasurable. Grief means great sadness. Immeasurable means too great. So who is sad on the death of her son? Mother India. And her grief, her sadness is immeasurable. It cannot be measured. Her pride at her son's heroic deeds surpasses her heart's despair. Surpasses, to do something better than somebody or something else. Despair, the state of having lost all hope. So Mother India is grief-stricken. She expresses the deep sense of sadness and grief felt by all Indians at the brutal killing of Indian soldiers. No one can measure the tears of grief of their mother. Their grief surpasses, means overcome, despair in the poet's heart. The loss of her son's life fills her with pain and suffering. Yet she hopes for a future where there will be no hate and terror. So children, the loss of her son's lives, here refers to Indian soldiers, had filled her with pain and suffering. Yet the poet is hopeful. She hopes that a day will soon come when the war caused by hatred would come to an end and peace would prevail in the world. She wishes of a world free from war, where life will be refashioned and filled with peace, where life will be remodeled and filled with peace. And what will come to an end? Yes, war will come to an end. Mother India asks the people to respect and honor the deeds of her martyred sons. So the Mother India, she tells the people that the sacrifice made by brave soldiers would be remembered by them with gratitude. They would be honored for their valor deeds. Coming generations would remember their sacrifices. Who sacrifices? द सेक्रीफाइसेज मेड बाय इंडियन सोल्जर्स फॉर द ब्रिटिश. द इंडियन सोल्जर्स वर नॉट नोइंग द रीजन वाई वर दे फाइटिंग, दे वर जस्ट फॉलोइंग द कमांड ऑफ देयर मास्टर. आई होप दैट यू आर क्लियर विद द समरी ऑफ द पोइम. नाउ लेट अस स्टार्ट विद द थीम. द थीम of the poem is patriotism. It is also given in your workbook. Sarojini Naidu's poetry is known for bringing out the depth of her patriotism for her country, that is India. Patriotism means loyalty of person to his or her own nation. It is believed that she wished to serve her nation with her songs. Sarojini Naidu's The Gift of India brings out her fervent patriotism. Fervent means showing very strong feelings about something. The poem is believed to have been written to attract the attention of the world to the brave soldiers of India who sacrificed their lives in different wars fought by the British during the First World War. So the poem written by Sarojini Naidu is a tribute to Indian soldiers who laid down their lives for Britishers during the First World War. The poem evokes a sense of pride as well as grief at the loss of a number of Indian soldiers who laid down their lives in the First World War. Evokes means to produce a feeling. Pride, a feeling of happiness that comes from achieving something. Grief, great sadness. So the poem arises a feeling of pride. Now why are we feeling pride? On the Indian soldiers who had fought bravely, and grief. Why are we sad? We are sad on the sacrifice made by Indian soldiers during the First World War. In this poem, Sarojini Naidu has personified Mother India. Personified means to be an example in human form of a particular quality, whose heart bleeds for her sons, who have been torn away from her bosom ruthlessly and deployed in foreign lands to serve British interests. So, ruthlessly means cruelly. Deployed means to put soldiers or weapons in a position where they are ready to fight. So, in the poem The Gift of India, the speaker is Mother India, who is personified as a human being. It is she whose voice is heard in the poem as a loving and caring mother. She recalls how her brave sons were snatched from her and were entrusted to their British masters. They did not know what they were fighting for. So, who did not know? The Indian soldiers, they did not know what they were fighting for. What was the reason of the fight? They were just fighting on the orders of their master. Now, let us see the next slide. The Indian soldiers displayed their strength and courage on different battle fronts, fighting for the Allied forces in the First World War. Allied forces means armies from different countries who are fighting on the same side in a war. They died unknown and unlamented and were gathered like pearls in their alien graves. Unlamented means not grieved for. So the Indian soldiers were the perfect example of the bravery. They were sincere and duty conscious. They were soldiers in the real sense of the term. They did not know the cause for which they were fighting in foreign lands. They had in mind the call to duty. They were so brave and courageous that they fought to the last. They sacrificed their lives, and their dead bodies lay scattered on the fields of Flanders. Flanders is previous name of Belgium and France. So she refers to the unattended bodies of those soldiers were like the flowers which are cut down casually and which lie scattered only to be trod upon mercilessly. Sarojini Naidu has portrayed a heart-rending picture of the dead soldiers in the battlefield. Heart-rending means making you feel very sad. So she has portrayed a horrifying picture of the battlefield. They have been depicted as lying motionless with severed limbs, resembling the shells that had been deserted by the living creatures within them. Severed means to cut something into two pieces. Limbs means a leg or an arm of a person. Deserted means left alone. As you know that pearls are taken out from shells, and when it is removed from shells, then those shells are thrown away on the beaches with oysters in it. In the same way, the dead bodies of the Indian soldiers with their cut limbs were lying on those unknown lands. Their motionless and disheveled bodies on the blood-stained battlefield have been compared with the withered beauty of flowers scattered in a sun-parched meadows. Disheveled means very untidy, blood-stained with marks of blood. Parched means very hot. She is continuing the pains of the Indian soldiers. She says that they lay there with their pale brows and broken hands. The dead bodies of her sons were spread like casually cut down flowers in the meadows of Flanders. Flanders, I have told you, previous name of Belgium and France. She believed that prayer was the only source of hope and solace for the anguished hearts that were filled with overwhelming sorrows at the loss of Indian soldiers in war. Solace, what does it mean? It means something that gives comfort. Anguished means suffering great mental pain. So the poet believes that the only source of hope and a thing which can give comfort to the mental suffering is the prayer. As a true patriot who wanted to see her country free from the shackles of the British rule, Sarojini Naidu visualized that good sense would prevail in the world and hatred would not take a toll of human lives. Shackles, clutches, prevails, exist, toll, harm or damage someone or something. So she visualized a world where there will be no hatred and no war, so that no harm is caused to the human lives. The only tribute that could be paid to those dead soldiers is not to forget the sacrifice they made for the cause of freedom. The only appeal of the poet is that those who got killed in the war should be shown proper respect and memorials should be erected in their memory. Means the sacrifice which they have made should not go worthless. Thus the poem The Gift of India is emotionally surcharged with sentiments of the poet towards the martyrs and the valiant sacrifice made by the sons of the Indian soil. Surcharged to fill or load to excess. Sentiments means emotions. Valiant means full of courage. So through the poem, the poet has filled your mind with the feeling of patriotism and respect to those martyrs who were courageous and sacrificed their lives for others. Now let us see the next slide. Very important background of the poem. Over 1 million Indian troops from Britain's colonial empire served in the British Army in the First World War. Means the Indian soldiers fought for the Britishers in the First World War. Nearly 75,000 died on foreign lands, referred by Naidu as pearls gathered in alien graves. Means the place where a dead body is buried. Grave means the place where a dead body is buried. So how many died in the World War? 75,000. Indian soldiers died in the First World War on the foreign lands where their dead bodies are lying in the grave, but they were unattended. The Indian troops were of vital significance in many battles of the First World War and served not only in the Ypres sector of the Western Front but also in Mesopotamia and Gallipoli. Ypres is a Belgian municipality in the province of West Flanders. During the First World War, it was the center of the battles of Ypres between German and Allied forces. So these were the places where the Indian troops were placed by the British in the First World War. There were large number of Indian soldiers who traveled from India to fight in the trenches of France and Belgium. Trenches means a long deep hole dug in the ground for soldiers to hide in during enemy attack. So these were the places where Indian soldiers fought battles for the British. Everywhere, be it Persia, Egypt, Flanders or France, Indian sons sacrificed their lives for the British cause, and thus Naidu says for them. So the Indian soldiers, as they were duty conscious, they were so sincere, they sacrificed their lives for the British in these places and for them. Sarojini Naidu quote these lines: "Silent they sleep by the Persian waves, scattered like shells on Egyptian sands. They lie with pale brows and brave broken hands. They are strewn like blossoms mown down by chance on the blood-brown meadows of Flanders and France." So the poet envisions terrifying scene of dead bodies of Indian soldiers lying unattended on the battlefields. This is a beautiful image that captures horror involved in any war. Thousands of dead bodies lie scattered like flowers, cut down casually. These dead bodies are not even buried properly. Now let us see the next slide. So the next topic is Mother India. The poem has personified the country India as the mother of all its people. The boundless grief of Mother India for her heroic sons who were killed in alien lands is expressed in the poem. One of the critics mentioned that it is India only, the great India, which represents itself as eternal Mother India, who loves her sons and daughters as a real mother does. So throughout the poem, the poet is not the speaker. The speaker of the poem is Mother India. She has been personified, that is, she has been given human attributes. The poet has used Mother India as mouthpiece so that she can tell how does a mother feel when her sons and daughters are taken away from her. Sarojini Naidu has presented Mother India in a unique and unforgettable way, where she considers the precious lives of her sons as her gift to the British. So she has given the most precious gift, that is her sons, to the British. The British cannot measure the grief encompassing her in losing the sons of her stricken womb, encompassing causing to take place. So she says that the grief which is caused to the Mother India on losing her sons cannot be measured by the British. They cannot estimate the pride that runs along the despair of her heart, yet she is interested in the sad but glorious vision of true freedom, where the terror and the tumult of hate shall cease. Tumult means disorder. So here Mother India hopes that one day terror and hate shall cease. Cease means stop. And it is then that life will be remodeled with newfound peace. Now let us see the next slide. Despite losing her numerous sons in the battlefield, she is hopeful and believes life will become anew on anvils of peace. Anvils means iron blocks. Here it means strong foundation. So life will be remodeled with newfound peace. The only request she makes to the British is that the brave Indian soldiers who died for their cause should be remembered and honored till the world lives. Mother India at the end demands only one thing from the British, that when out of love, they will offer thanks and respect to the soldiers who fought valiantly. They should remember the brave soldiers of India who sacrificed their lives. Now let us see the next point, that is anti-war poem. anti-war poem means the poem which is telling that there should not be any war. Ever since the time of the ancient Greek, literature has glorified war heroes. Glorified, described in a way that makes something seem more important than it really is. So they had always given a good picture of the war heroes. They have made the war seem like a worthwhile, honorable, and romantic endeavors. Endeavors means to make an effort. The writers have described wars as something worth going for, honorable and romantic efforts, which was actually far from reality of the true nature of war. For the most part, war, although tragic, was viewed as necessary and in many ways romantic. Tragic means that makes you very sad, especially because it involves death. So children, as we know, the outcome of wars, it always causes disaster. But at that time, wars were considered very important and romantic. Here it means something far from reality. It means the bright side of wars were shown to the readers. Now let us see the next slide. This notion was shattered at the beginning of the 20th century by the horrors of the First World War, termed as the Great War. Notion means idea. So the idea of war being glorious came to an end at the beginning of the 20th century when the Great War was fought. This war brought about a great change in the minds of Westerners who had grown accustomed to the rosy pictures painted by the romantic and Victorian authors, painters and poets. Rosy picture, what does it mean? It means to make something sound very good. So during that time, the authors, painters and poets always highlighted the bright side of the war. But after the First World War, the readers came to know what the war was in real sense. Now let us see the next slide. The number of deaths caused by the Great War, the inhumane nature of trench warfare, introduction of new deadly chemical weapons such as the chlorine gas and the mustard gas, the conditions under which the soldiers were made to live and fight appear to be the antithesis of what civilized existence was supposed to be. So the meaning of word inhumane means very cruel. Trench, a long deep hole dug in the ground for soldiers to hide in during enemy attack. Warfare, methods of fighting a war. So at that time, the soldiers were hidden in trenches, that is tunnels, so that they could hide and fight with enemies. The meaning of what antithesis mean is the opposite of something. So after the First World War, all these sufferings of the soldiers came in front of the readers and they came to know how deadly the wars were. Soldiers were kept in trenches so that they could fight, but while serving in trenches, they suffered from great illness and various diseases. Chemical weapons such as chlorine and mustard gas were very deadly, and the conditions of the soldiers were very pathetic in that time. So all these things are just opposite to our civilized existence. Means we show ourselves very civilized, but still these inhumane treatment are done with the soldiers. Sarojini Naidu's The Gift of India, though a patriotic poem, can be read as anti-war poem at one level. Naidu, through this poem, has depicted the horrors of war through the brutal killing of the Indian soldiers in the First World War. Brutal means very cruel. So she has highlighted how brutally the Indian soldiers were killed on the alien lands. These Indian soldiers were used as pawns in the war by the British. Pawns here means a person who is used or controlled by other more powerful people. So they were like puppets in the hands of the British. They were in no way involved in the cause or outcome of the war, but they were unscrupulously deployed for the benefit of the British. Unscrupulously means dishonestly. Deployed means to put soldiers or weapons in a position where they are ready to fight. So they did not know what they were fighting for. They were just following the commands of their master. These soldiers fought in alien lands and died on the battlefield. They could never reunite with their country and their families. Reunite means to come together again. Their dead bodies lied buried in the alien land. Dead bodies were not brought to their mother land. Their dead bodies lay lifeless, like the shells scattered on sands. Their severed limbs and disheveled, blood-stained bodies are proof enough of the horrors of war, which these soldiers had to face. So I have discussed with you all the consequences of wars which the Indian soldiers had faced. Thus, the immeasurable grief of Mother India in the poem reflects Naidu's anti-war attitude. Throughout the poem, war is not glorified but condemned. Mother India throughout laments the loss of her children. Condemned means to express strong disapproval. Laments means to express sorrow. So till now we have read that the dead bodies of Indian soldiers lay scattered in fields unattended. The sorrow and sufferings of Mother India can never be comprehended. And the poet has reflected beautifully all these feelings through Mother India, which has been personified. Mother India is crying over the loss of Indian soldiers can be seen as a reflection of every mother lamenting the loss of her martyred sons. So she has used Mother India as the mouthpiece for the number of mothers who had lost their sons on the battlefield. The soldiers, their families are thus the victims of any war encompassing loss and bloodshed. Victims means a person who has been hurt or taken advantage of. Encompassing means causing. So the loss faced by the family of the person who had died in the war can never be comprehended by anyone. She visualizes a day when the world would be free from hatred and agonies of war and life would be modeled on the newfound peace. Agonies means pains. Model means formed. So the poet hopes that soon the surge of hate and violence would come to an end. Life would be refashioned on strong foundation of peace. I hope that you are clear with the points which I have discussed with you in this session. Your homework is to revise theme of the poem The Gift of India on pages 64 till 65 of workbook. And you have to plan word meanings of the poem on the textbook. Children, I would again like to mention, you have to revise the poem thoroughly so that you can quote the important lines from the poem and keywords to score good in your paper. Thank you.